I'm Roslyn Nieves.
And I'm Cliff Jacobs.
Welcome to Queens Perspectives.
Did you recently go to the Queens Council on the Arts Fab at 50 dance party without me?
Yes, I did. I had to. The executive director for Queens Council on the Arts, Ms. Hung Yee Lee Krakow, went all out. You have to take a look at this clip. Your hands together.
Yeah.
For the ladies.
Yeah.
For the gentlemen who are Nona Hendrix, the Queen of Queens. Yeah. Will Calhoun on drums.
Yeah, baby.
Woo-hoo. And we got DJ Rampage. Woo. Put your hands together for a rockin' time. Let's go.
Yeah.
Knows how to throw a party, and she had Nona Hendrix as her headliner? Wow, I want to give love a try.
I know you do. That's just the beginning. Nona kept turning it up.
Get out. Nona needed me there to do some dancing.
Listen, that's enough. Please roll that clip. Give him some music.
And Will Calhoun from In Living Color, bassist Warren McRae, and guitarist Ronnie Drayton. Wow, the ladies were nice looking. That is so hot. I wish I was there.
I know you do. And you should have been there.
Did any of our political leaders attend the party?
Yes, they did. Queensborough President Melinda Katz, Senator Michael Gianaris, Councilmember Jimmy Van Bramer, and Nick Gulotta from the mayor's office. Take a look.
Good evening. We love being in this park. We love giving Manhattan the view that it deserves. Let me thank our majority leader, Jimmy Van Bramer, also chair of cultural affairs. Queens is really thriving under his leadership. Let me thank him. Yay! To our great Senator Michael Gianaris, to Michael Gianaris, yay! Hung Yee, who is a fantastic leader at the helm of this great ship. And to Jana, chair of the board, who is the chair of a fantastic group of folks that care deeply about the future of our great borough. And Jana, thank you for your leadership. So 50 years ago, Jean Dale Katz, my mom, founded the Queens Council on the Arts. And many of you know that David Katz, her husband, my dad, founded the Queens Symphony Orchestra. And to this day, the story in the family is that my mom founded this organization solely so she wasn't upstaged by her husband. But they had a vision. You know, Jean Dale Katz was a singer in the USO. She entertained troops in a duet during World War II, all across Asia, entertaining folks that were at war for our country. And when my parents met and they moved to Jackson Heights and then moved to Forest Hills, Queens, they knew the future of this borough was in the culture. They knew that when folks were coming from all over the world to this place, to this great borough, that they'd be bringing with them their arts and their culture and their language and their religion and their instruments and their voices. And they wanted it to grow right here in Queens. And Queens Council on the Arts, through the individual folks that are involved here, through all the organizations that I see represented here, and I think it's a great tribute to the Council on the Arts that there are so many great organizations that are here today as well. The legacy has continued, and Queens has proven that you don't have to go over a bridge or under a tunnel to get great culture and arts. You get it right here in our great borough of Queens. So thank you to Council on the Arts for your leadership. And on behalf of, if I could ask the other elected officials to join me as I present a proclamation of honor to Hongyi and to Jana. Because I love all of you and many of you supported me in the past, and I'd like you to support me again, I'm not gonna read the whole thing. But I will say this is a proclamation on behalf of the Borough President's Office and all the electeds up here. Queens Council on the Arts was founded in 1966 by Jean Delcasse to foster and develop the arts in the Queens County. Whereas Queens Council on the Arts serves as an umbrella organization to promote great culture and arts in the borough of Queens. Whereas after 50 years of existence, the Queens Council on the Arts remains committed to celebrating and promoting cultural diversity. I, therefore, Melinda Katz, President of the Borough of Queens, do hereby proclaim May 26th as Queens Council on the Arts Day in the Borough of Queens. Congratulations.
There's no better place in Queens for culture and the arts than right here in Long Island City and Western Queens. So thank you all for the tremendous work you do. I, too, have a resolution sponsored by the Queens members of the State Senate honoring this day, the 50th anniversary of the Queens Council on the Arts. And let me just say, it's good to hear that history because neither Melinda nor Jimmy nor I are older than this organization. So we have to learn about how it started. Melinda's younger than each of us, so don't worry about it.
I'm older.
No, it's okay. Melinda's the youngest of all of us up here. And I'll spare you reading it as well because it says a lot of the same things that the borough president's proclamation said. But congratulations on 50 great years and look forward to another 50.
Nick Kulaka is in the house and he is the representative from Mayor de Blasio with yet another proclamation. Yay! We're rocking him up here.
Thank you very much. So very quickly, I won't read this entire thing, but there is a very special surprise at the end of it. The surprise is that, little do you know, today is actually Queens Council of the Arts Day in the city of New York. So a very brief read. Through investments in arts and education, increasing in affordable housing and workspaces for artists, and free memberships to cultural institutions for IDNYC holders, thank you, and Jimmy, thank you. IDNYC holders, we are making great progress towards our goal of encouraging all New Yorkers to participate in the arts.
Well, it's really nice to see our legislators supporting the arts.
Yes, it is. And I got a soundbite from our borough president and council member Jimmy Van Bramer right before the band played. Take a look.
What a wonderful day for QCA's Fab and 50 party.
It's beautiful day, beautiful to be here. 50 never looked so good, right, here in Long Island City. So it's great. It's a great organization. Long before I was elected, I served on the board here. I was president of Queens Council on the Arts over 10 years ago, and so I would never miss celebrating 50 years of culture and the arts in Queens. It's great.
Awesome. Tell us a little bit about your district. What does it encumber?
Well, all of Long Island City, which you can see here, is God's country, one of the most beautiful places in the world, and the equally wonderful neighborhoods of Sunnyside and Woodside and a portion of Astoria where I grew up. So much of Western Queens, where so much is happening, so many new folks are moving into Queens, where art and culture lives and thrives and where so many artists are. So I think I represent the coolest, the hippest, the funnest district in all of New York City.
I have to agree. Now they're going to have, as a headliner, Nona Hendrix. Did you grow up listening? listening to her music?
You know, as an old man now, I can say that I have more appreciation for the music and the talent and the artistry. So I've become a fan. You know, when I was growing up in the late 70s, I became a fan of disco. And so I'm a little bit more of like ABBA and Donna Summer and stuff like that. But, you know, I can get into anything.
Last question. Are we going to see you dance later?
You know, if I'm here long enough, the folks might be lucky enough to see me dance, because I can't paint, I can't sing, but I can damn sure dance.
Awesome. President Melinda Katz, thank you for joining me.
My pleasure, thank you.
You look beautiful, and what a wonderful day for the 50th anniversary, am I correct?
It is a wonderful day. We're out here celebrating 50 years of Queens Council on the Arts. We have a great view of Queens and, you know, an okay view of Manhattan.
That's right. I agree with you. We don't need to go over the water. We need to stay here in Queens. Now, your mom was an organizer, founder of Queens Council on the Arts. So how special is this day for you, 50 years?
This is a great day for us. And it's a great day for my family. My mother founded the Queens Council on the Arts. I still insist it was because she didn't want to be shown up by her husband, who founded the Queens Symphony Orchestra. And, you know, since then, the organization has grown, and it gives all these young artists the opportunity to make it in a very, very difficult industry.
That's true.
So I'm happy to be here, and it's interesting because I remember the 30th anniversary in which I was the honoree.
Oh, very nice, very nice.
20 years ago.
Oh, I got to get that picture. You got to send me that picture. We would want that picture. Now tell me, what are you doing to promote culture in Queens? What is your office doing?
Well, we have a great Department of Cultural Affairs in my office, and we work hard on tourism. But we promote these concerts all over the borough. We do a Cats concert series where we have 6-7 concerts. And it's all free, and it's all able to be seen by the entire family. And it's an exciting time to be in Queens.
Now, I also read on your website that you have a competition for the Pavilion. Tell us about that.
Yes, we have a competition for the Pavilion. As you know, the New York State Pavilion has been saved officially. There's about $15 million or so in order to fix it up and light it up so it becomes a beautiful part of the Queens skyline. And there's a competition as to what to do with it. And there's been some very interesting ideas so far, all the way from sci-fi to, you know, making the 3 discs cheeseburgers. And it's just a fascinating thing to see what people view it as. But at the end of the day, we'll get some great ideas, we'll save it, it'll be lit up, and it's beautiful.
Excellent. Now tell us a little bit about the Queens Symphony Orchestra. What are they doing, you know, differently this year? And what are you doing to still foster that, you know, old music here in Queens?
Queens Symphony Orchestra just had its 65th anniversary a few weeks ago. I was honored to have sung at the concert.
What did you sing?
I sang On My Own from Les Miserables, and I sang If I Were a Bell from Guys and Dolls.
Very nice, very nice.
If I were a bell, I'd be ringing. So it was a lot of fun, and they honored my father, my mother, and honored the 65 years that the Queens Symphony has serviced the borough. And, you know, my father had this vision that Queens was going to be, and was at the time, but really was going to become, a whole borough of folks coming in from all over the world. And all over the world, they were going to bring their culture and their arts and their religion and their language and all of the great things that they learn in different countries. And that they were going to come to Queens and share it with each other. And he was a great visionary in that. And we fulfilled that.
And we have.
It's a place to be, and the Queens Symphony Orchestra responds to those needs.
Excellent. Now, who's the contact person at your office for culture and tourism?
We have Nayeli Valencia, who is here with us today. She is a dancer and a lawyer.
Wow, I didn't know that. Very nice.
But we certainly have a lot of interest in promoting the culture and the arts in Queens. We want to make sure that when people come to the city of New York to visit,
that they haven't really seen New York City until they've seen Queens.
I agree. One last question. Now, Nona Hendrix is going to be headlining today. Are we going to see you dancing at all?
You might see me dancing, just not singing.
Okay. And we'll try to catch that. Thank you.
It's my pleasure. Thank you.
So you have Councilmember Jimmy Van Brammer dancing to DJ Rampage Global's jams. What about the borough president?
Well, the borough president, she wasn't doing any dancing. She was taking a lot of pictures, socializing.
And where was this event held at?
It was held at LIC Landing in Long Island City, right on the water at a waterfront park.
Wow, that is too much bragging. Let's go to a Nona Hendrix tribute to Queens Council on the Arts.
Like I said, okay, everyone knows this song. Play it.
Has to be Lady Marmalade.
That's right.
Voulez-vous?
Your turn. I need some people interested in getting their yayas tonight. Come on, don't be shy. We're not teenagers. We're not kiddies. So I know most of you have gotten your yayas at some point. Yes? Okay. So I need a couple of people to come up here and get some yayas with me. Who's gonna come on up? Guys, you're never gonna get any yayas if there's nothing but ladies up here. Thank you, coming to the rescue of the ladies. Oh, yes you are. If you haven't been to Pilates, come back. Come back. I saw you skip out. Alright. If you haven't been to Pilates, if you haven't stretched, if you haven't been to the gym, now's your time. And one, two.
Dropping it like it's hot and kept the whole place a rocket.
Any other well-wishers?
Yes, there were. Queens Botanical Garden. Take a look at this clip.
Hi, I am Jessica Bry, the Marketing and Development Associate at Queens Botanical Garden. Congratulations on being fabulous in 50, QCA.
I'm Susan Lassert, Executive Director of Queens Botanical Garden, the place where people, plants, and cultures meet. And we want to congratulate Queens Council on the Arts on their 50th year. And here's to another 50 years, another 50 flower-filled years.
I see that the community came out in full force to support this event.
Yes, and Miss Heidi Howard won Queens Council on the Arts event logo contest.
Can you bring up her logo? And congratulations, Heidi.
Yes, congratulations, Miss Heidi.
How about any other interviews? Did you get any?
Yeah, I got to talk to Miss Nona Hendricks and Mr. Will Calhoun. Take a look.
The presentation for QCA's 50 and Fabulous was just off the chart. Everybody was rocking.
Thank you.
Wonderful.
I had a great time. Thank you. It's really, look at this setting. It's really amazing. A beautiful day, beautiful people, and for a beautiful reason. For art.
You're absolutely right. And it's a shame that they take art and culture out of the schools. We need to put it back.
Absolutely. I mean, that's what's part of what I do in terms of working with Berklee College of Music in Boston. That's part of my mission, is to help grow another sort of generation of artists who will teach as well as perform. And it's very important, you know, music, painting, writing, poetry, dance. They're great ways to express yourself and express things that you may not be able to say to someone.
Now, you've done so many things. Singer, actor, musician, author, record producer. How do you transition to so many things? This is inspiring for children, adults, and women, definitely women, wanting to do different things, because sometimes they think after they've done one thing that that's it. It doesn't have to be.
No, never. I mean, I think if you have a passion for something, then try it. See if it stays with you. If it doesn't stay with you, look for the other thing that you have passion for. And also reach higher than where you are, because a lot of people will say, you know, no, you can't do this, no, you can't do that, because you are this, you are that. And no one person is just this or just that. And we need every one of us on the planet to bring forth their gifts that they were given, because they're the only one who can do it, you know?
Now, in your early years, tell me what you're most proud of. And I know this is very hard, especially since you've done so much, but just tell me, give me a couple of highlights of things that you're most proud of. What's your first paying gig?
Oh, I think that was like $9 when I was 14 or 15 years old in Trenton, New Jersey. But I think one of the things I'm most proud of is being a part of LaBelle, which is really, we were together for 17 years and basically grew up together and, you know, became adults together. And one of the highlights of our career was, you know, Voulez-vous coucher avec moi ce soir, Lady Marmalade, and also a lot of the music that we performed that I wrote, and developing into a writer and writing songs for LaBelle about social, political, feminine injustice, also just about being a woman in the world. So I'm very, very, very proud of that. And also playing the Metropolitan Opera House as three African-American women who were in considered rock or funk or gospel hybrid music. That was a very big moment in our lives. And I think there's so many other things, but, you know, those are highlights for me.
Now, the band today, how did that marriage come about? They were absolutely wonderful. The support, I mean, one of the young ladies at the last minute, she wanted one more song, and they were like, and then they did it.
The song that Will Calhoun, the drummer, who is actually the catalyst that brought us here today, Will is a member of Living Color, the amazing rock metal band with Vernon Reed and Corey and Doug Wimbush. And Will asked me to do about doing this, and I said, but I'm not from Queens, I'm from New Jersey. He said, yeah, but all of your band members have been from Queens, so you're a queen of Queens. I said, okay. And Ronnie Drayton, who is from Jamaica, Queens, and has been with me since 1982, is one of my funk babies. And Warren McRae, who's also from Queens, from Jamaica, Queens, he's been with me since, I think, probably 1988, 89, maybe 90s. And Etienne, who has been with me for quite a few years, he's not from Queens. They've been with me a long time. And Asa, Arnold, Keith Fluitt, and Kiki Hawkins, they've been with me for over 10 years, maybe 15 years. So they're like family. They're my funketeers, and, you know, we have fun. We like to enjoy the music we make, and they're all super talented people.
I saw that. Everybody was super, super duper talented.
They are individually. I mean, they're just really. They say you're as good as the company you keep. I keep very good company.
That's excellent. Now, what did you think about Queens Council on the Arts? You saw how many people came out to support them. It's important to keep art and culture in the community, and especially when there's so much, there's so little money put into art and culture. We got to bring it back. Yes. What did you think about the organization as a not-for-profit serving the community?
I tell you, I think they have a lot of power in their passion for what it is that they're doing. And, you know, as I said, Mama Rosa, Hung Yi, and they're the first two people I met. They made me feel at home. I went to Mama Rosa's restaurant, sat down. She fed me like crazy. And the other people that I've met here, it's very much, it's a community. And it's changing. I used to come here when the Talking Heads lived over here in an old, sort of factory space. And it wasn't like this at all. It's changed an awful lot. And so it's really wonderful to see the changes, but also see the spirit of the place stay the same. And I hope that doesn't go away, because you can build as many buildings as you want, but if you don't have the spirit of the people, doesn't mean a thing.
It's true.
So it's this, for me, the spirit is still here in the people that I met.
Okay, one last question. What's your recommendation for our youth in our community to keep them moving forward? How should they, like, avoid pitfalls and stuff in the industry? What's your recommendation?
Well, you know, it's a very difficult thing. I just said to somebody that, you know, the arts, or specifically in music, but any form, it's not for the faint-hearted. You know, you have valleys and peaks, and it's important to enjoy the peaks when you have them, and understand that the valleys are only just the opposite of a peak, that it's going to change at some point. And stay focused on what it is that you do, not what other people are doing, you know, unless you can learn from them. But stay focused on your creativity, your gifts that you've been given, and do it whether you earn money from it or not, because if you love it and it's a passion, you're going to do it no matter what.
One last thing. I said that was the last question, but I can't help but ask. Any more reunion with Miss Patti LaBelle?
No, you know what? I think we did it. We were together for 17 years. We had a reunion in 2009, I think it was. And I think it's a wonderful memory. I think it's like, leave that wonderful memory there for people. There's lots of videos on YouTube, lots of information everywhere. And, you know, I think we did it.
I agree. Yes. Not only that, you are a wonderful performer, and it was an honor to interview you today. Thank you so much for joining me.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank
you. Thank you. I'm with Will Calhoun. That presentation was absolutely fabulous. Thank you so much for that.
It's a pleasure to be here. Thank you. Enjoy. With Nona Hendrix, you can't go wrong.
You're absolutely right. You have to tell me, who inspired you to play the drums? When did you start playing the drums?
You know what? My community inspired me. My older brother played. I listened to the radio all the time. I played in church. I did everything possible. So it's quite a few people. But my older brother would be the first victim of that inspiration.
Now, I want you to definitely name drop. What are some of the different groups that you played with? And just name drop just a little bit.
I play with Living Color. I work with the Stones. I work with Madonna. I work with some great jazz musicians, Pharoah Saunders, Wayne Shorter. I work with Mos Def, produced Mos Def, Herb Albert, some African artists, Salif Keita, Umu Sangari. Run DMC, Public Enemy, Talib Kweli, a lot of different artists. I love music, so it varies.
Very nice. So music has actually changed your life. What recommendations do you have for our youth to stay focused in music?
They should pick up an instrument. It's not a computer, it's not a cell phone. An instrument is something that you get married to, you learn, you practice, you carry with you. You learn responsibility, you learn patience, you learn how to focus, and you can have fun, too. So that's one of the main things I recommend for the younger folks to do.
Thank you. We'll get home.
Thank you, Princess.
Did you interview any of the community organizers?
Yes, celebrity chef and QCA board member Gianna Cherbone-Tioli. She does a lot of philanthropic work in the community. Take a look.
Thank you for joining me.
Thank you.
Now, Gianna, this was a wonderful event. How did this all come together? I know you were working with Hungry Lee Crack Hour to pull this together.
We wanted to make it a fun party. We wanted a great DJ, and we wanted someone who was actually representing Queens and what we feel and how important the arts are. And there was nobody more important than Nona and Will, because they're so intertwined with the arts. Nona being a fantastic artist, and so is Will. Most people don't know, but he's an incredible artist. And I think that just the fact that we wanted to work with people who really understood what we stand for and what Queens is about and what Queens Council of the Arts is about. So we wanted to have a great 50th, you know, fabulous 50th birthday party, and we figured the best place is here because we have the best view. We have the best, I have to say, local politicians. They're so supportive. It's amazing.
They did come out to support.
Say something. Hong Yi and I and the rest of the board work really well together, and we're very fortunate. Thank you.
Thank you, Jonas.
That really was a nice night. What about Hong Yi, the executive director of QCA?
Well, Hong Yi was turning up. She was dancing up a storm. This was her night to celebrate, and she had a lot to celebrate. Take a look. I'm going to go to the hospital.
why you skip out.
Hongyi, thank
yours
you for joining
truly. Hello, Rosalind Nieves.
Hello, Miss Hongyi.
How are you? Welcome to the party.
This was fabulous.
I'm so glad you were here, and I'm glad QPTV, as always, is in the house so that you could share our party with all of you fabulous people, because we're Fab 50, but you are truly fabulous.
That's right. Now, it took a lot to pull this together. Tell us what went into planning this type of program. It was wonderful on the waterfront, Long Island City, beautiful view, beautiful people, beautiful weather. You lucked out.
I made a phone call.
I made a phone call to God.
I made a phone call. You know, when you turn 50, not us personally, right, Russ?
No.
But when your organization turns 50 and it is a momentous, wonderful time, people come together. So I was really lucky to have my staff, my board, my junior board, the artists, and great people like Will Calhoun, who curated that whole musical piece for us. Nona Hendrix jumped right on, said, hey, listen, I'm coming in. I'm going to be with my Queen's Cats. So we had a lot of positive energy coming in.
She was rocking it. She was rocking it hard.
You were rocking it. I saw you were rocking it. We were all rocking it.
Now, my viewers want to participate. Tell them about some of your programs and services so that they can be rocking it too.
Well, if you want to rock out with us, Queens Council on the Arts, we're at www.queenscouncilarts.org. We got grants for you. We have professional development for you. We could teach you how to get a grant. We could teach you how to get to yes, so you could get your work out there in a really big way. So check us out, see what fits, and stop in anytime. Our doors are open.
Thank you. That's it for today's show. If you missed any part of the program, just visit our website at qptv.org. And I'll see you next time on Queens Perspectives.
She helped you close the segment.
She sure did.
Looks like everyone had a really great time. How about we go out with Nona Hendrix? And thanks for watching.
Crazy and insane. Well, if you wanna make the rules, you got.
when I learned about the Queens Council, I learned about the HS to AS program, high school to art school, which I'm very strong into education, and I absolutely fell in love with the idea. And I started learning more about what they do for the community, and I joined. And it has been fantastic. It's a wonderful organization.
I know. Yeah.